2.3 times 10, 23. 3.47 times 1,000, did you get 3470? What about 4.729 times 9.81? Or 0.53 divided by 1,000? But wait, without a calculator, in under 5 seconds, because there is no calculator on the MCAT.
2.3 times 10? Easy.
Because obviously you know that 1 times 10 equals 10, 2 times 10 is 20, 3 times 10 is 30. But how did you know that? Meaning, what did you do? You had a number and multiplied it by 10 by simply adding a 0. Add a 0 and add a 0. So 23 times 10 add a 0 gives me 230. Does 2.3 times 10 get a 0 for 2.30? Those darn decimals. 2.30 is just 2.3, which is exactly the number we started with. So let's change the rule. To multiply by 10, you add a decimal space. But wait, what decimal? Every number has an imaginary decimal at the end. To multiply by 10, we move the decimal one space to the right, fill in any missing zeros, and so one decimal times 10 gives me 10 decimal, or just 10. Two decimal times 10 is one space to the right for 20 decimal. Three times 10 gives me 30 decimal. And so 2.3 times 10, move the decimal one space to the right for a final answer of 23. What if you have more than one zero, like 37 times 100? 100 is really just 10 times 10, because every zero is another 10 and another decimal. 37 times 100 means you added two zeros because you moved the decimal twice for 3700. You move the decimal one space per zero when multiplying by a number that has one followed by zeros. With this in mind, can you solve 3.47 times 1,000 in your head? We count three zeros and move the decimal three spaces to the right, fill in the missing zero, for a final answer of 3,470. What about a potential MCAT question asking how many grams in 0.54 kilograms of glucose? Here is the long way, as I teach in my stoichiometry series linked below, but I want you to be able to do this quickly in your head. 0.54 times 1,000, three zeros, move the decimal three spaces to the right, fill in the missing zero, for a final answer of 540 grams. The trick to do in your head is recognize that 0.54 only has two decimal spaces, and so you have to add a zero for the third decimal space. If you have to divide by a factor of 10, for example, 30 divided by 10, well, if 3 times 10 is 30, then 30 divided by 10 should be 3. If multiplication has us moving the decimal to the right, division should have us move the decimal to the left, and so 30 decimal divided by 10, which is 1 zero, gives us 1 decimal to the left for an answer of 3. Try 470 divided by 100. Decimal, invisible, 100 has 2 zeros, so we move it back 1, 2 spaces for a final answer of 4.70 or 4.7. What if you're starting with decimals, such as this MCAT style question, how many kilograms in 0.53 grams of glucose? Here's the setup as I teach in my stoichiometry series below, but for this math trick, we're just looking at 0.53 divided by 1,000. 1,000 has three zeros. Divide means we move the decimal three spaces to the left and fill in the missing zero. And this is where students get stuck. This right here is my decimal. That means I need to have one more zero to show where the decimal begins. For a final answer of 0.00053, something they'll likely want in scientific notation, which I cover in another video. What if there's no factor of 10, such as the MCAT asking you to find the weight of a 4.729 gram sample of glucose, given that the gravitational acceleration is 9.81 meters per second squared? I cover gravity in my physics series below, but the math here is 4.729 times 9.81. Can we still use the trick without any tens? Actually, yes, because on the MCAT, close enough is good enough and rounding is your best friend. 9.81 is about 10, and 10 has a zero. Grab that decimal, move it one space to the right,
and we get an answer that is approximately 47.
Calculator says 46.39, which is close enough. How about 5.29 times 1,000, or 3.27 times 9.73? Practice questions like these on my MCAT math worksheet at leahforsci.com/MCAT math linked below. What if you can't round to a factor of 10, like 0.089 times 213, or 3.17 times 10 to the minus 2 times 791, still without a calculator? That's exactly what I cover in my next video, which you can find on my website along with my MCAT math worksheet, practice quiz, and cheat sheet at layoffyoursci.com/MCATmath.